Hey guys, this is Abhishek from Technics Media. Today we are here at CES 2013 at the Sony booth, and here we have the Sony Xperia ZL with us. Our trimmed down hardware variant of Sony Xperia Z. This is how the device looks like. If we talk about the display size of the device, it has got 5-inch display, which is again the same if you compare it with Sony Xperia Z. If we talk about the build quality, on the back you have a little curved back, which is quite easy to hold in hand. It gives you a nice grip, but on Sony Xperia Z you have a flat glossy black, which is completely flat. There are no curves, but on this one you have the curves on the edges, so it becomes easy to hold this particular device. The weight of Sony Xperia ZL, it is actually higher than Sony Xperia Z. And if we talk about the display on Sony Xperia ZL is TFT, capacitive touchscreen display, 16 million colors, and with a pixel density of around 441 pixels per inch, which is quite same which you see on Sony Xperia Z as well. This is how the lock screen looks like, which is similar to Sony Xperia Z. You do have the option to launch the camera by dragging the camera application icon, and you can also launch the music UI, the music control from here. And if you want to unlock the phone, you have a nice animation with which you can actually unlock the phone like this. And once you unlock it, you will see the regular standard Xperia UI on this phone as well. This phone is again a prototype, not the final version of Xperia ZL, but this one is against shatterproof and scratch resistant glass. It has got a Corning Gorilla Glass technology. The display resolution of this particular device is 1080x1920 pixels. We talk about the micro SD card. It has the internal storage, which is 16 GB. However, the Sony Xperia Z comes with 32 GB of internal storage, and this one comes with around 16 GB of internal storage, and out of which around 14 GB should be available to the user. If we talk about the RAM, the Sony Xperia ZL has 2 GB of RAM, which is similar to Sony Xperia Z as well. This phone is pretty similar in terms of the design to Sony Xperia Z, but there are some difference, like the camera, the front camera is located over here at the bottom, whereas on the Sony Xperia Z it is on the top. The back side of Sony Xperia ZL is texturized with curved edges over here, but on Sony Xperia Z it is the flat glossy black glossy back which you see. We have already done a video on Sony Xperia Z, so you can watch that video to actually see the visual differences. If you talk about the location of the power button and the volume key, the volume rocker, this is the location of power button, which is right now on Sony Xperia Z and ZL in the middle, so it becomes easy to actually access the power button on this 5-inch display size device. The volume rocker is over here, whereas the volume rocker on Sony Xperia ZL is below the power button, so which is again more accessible. You have a dedicated camera shutter key over here on the Sony Xperia ZL on the right hand side at the bottom. If we take a look over the device, on the left side of the device we have nothing. On the top we have nothing apart from the 3.5mm audio jack. If we take a look on the right side, we have the volume rocker, which can be clicked from upside and downside. It is a single button. Here we have the power key, which is quite above the edge on the phone. If you take a look, it is quite above the edge. And here we have the camera shutter key on the right bottom, and then at the bottom of the phone we have the slot for the mic. This is the hole for the mic, as you can see. And if you actually are going to wonder about where you can actually increase the storage of the device by inserting the micro SD memory card, here we have the slot for the micro SD memory card, where you can actually see the micro SD memory card slot and the SIM card slot. So you have a micro SD memory card slot over here. SIM card will go over here on this device from the back side. There might be some variation when it comes to the market in final. If we talk about the Android version which runs on this device, let me show you the Android version. Let me just go into settings and show you the Android version. So the Android version is 4.1.2, that is Jelly Bean operating system, which is again quite nice on this device. So this comes preloaded with the Jelly Bean operating system. One thing which we actually liked about the device is there is a little green light at the bottom which keeps on glowing when you use the device. This is again gives, this again is kind of a very unique light which you might not have seen on any other phones apart from Sony. The Sony Xperia Z phones or Sony Xperia series phones normally have a nice light at the bottom on the phone. Then if we take a look over these buttons, which is for the back, for the home button and the multitasking key, these buttons are actually within the screen, not on the body of the phone. And here you have the camera, the front camera located. The front camera is located over here. If we access the notification, this is how the notification bar looks like, as you can see. If you want to know the overall camera UI, this is how the camera UI looks. It is a full screen camera UI which you have, in which you have the buttons over here, the camera shutter key as well as the record button, as well as you can take the photos while you are doing the video recording on this device. There are some photos which have been captured on this device using the camera, which will give you an idea about the quality of the camera which this device has. So the Sony Xperia ZL also has the 13 megapixel camera, as you can see. This is a 13 megapixel camera with LED flash, and here you have a hole for the mic for the noise cancellation. This is the secondary mic, and the primary mic is over here, as you can see. So this phone is again quite nice as far as the overall software which you see on the device. The overall picture quality from the camera is quite good. Again, for the macro shots, it works pretty well in low light as well as in normal light. It does have the flash as well. If you want to know about the video recording, you can record high definition video using the back camera of the device with 30 frames per second, and the secondary camera which is here at the bottom is 2 megapixel camera which can shoot the videos at 720p with 30 frames per second again. So the overall UI has been optimized and designed and customized in such a way that you can actually feel the usability in such a way that you can access all the applications easily. The UI makes sense because it does come with all the applications which you will need, like the Gmail application, the default Google application, as well as the Xperia Link application which you would need. You have an office suite as well so that you can edit the documents on this phone. So the overall design, as well as the design in terms of the hardware as well as the software of this phone, is quite good. So that's all from us right now regarding the quick hands-on review of Sony Xperia ZL. This phone is probably going to come in the market pretty soon. So let's keep watching about this device. Stay tuned, and you can ask us any query regarding this device. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.